It's the 2K Sports pregame show, brought to you by Kia.
Hello, everybody. Glad you could join us here on 2K Sports. I'm your host, Ernie Johnson. Next to me, Kenny the Jet Smith and Dr. Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, it'll be the Philadelphia 76ers going up against the Miami Heat. For Miami, they are really playing at a high level right now, going 8-1.
It's game time in Philadelphia as the crowds at Wells Fargo Center look to cheer on the 76ers. Hi, everyone. We're happy to have you with us for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry. David Aldridge will join us momentarily from the sidelines. And, of course, Hassan Whiteside. I think they'll miss the size that he gave this team.
And to say the deal changes the look and the feel of this franchise, quite frankly, is stating the obvious. They are a vastly different team than they were just a few days ago, obviously looking long-term rather than short.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. On the court for the Heat, James Johnson is out there with Chris Bosh. Then there's Dragic. Then it's Amir Johnson. And it's Bradley in at the two. And so much can change between now and the end of the season. Brent, have you ever had seasons that started poorly but ended much better, or vice versa?
Well, there's no question that as you get deeper into the season, a lot of things can change. Injury can disrupt that process. And then the trade deadline can always be really interesting, Kevin, with new moves and new personnel coming in, and that can shift the mentality of a ball club. So, got to stick with it mentally, continue to do your job. You got to stick with the process, Kevin, and the season will end up being exactly what it's meant to be.
And that one's good, Simmons.
So what an incredible effort from Simmons, using his length so well when he's hitting the board.
Dragic kicks to Johnson. He dishes it to Johnson. Back to Johnson. That's good, and it's Johnson with the assist.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
Hey, paid attention in arts and crafts school right there. Didn't have to work very hard at all for that one.
Now here's Simmons. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Phoenix.
Felt like he was just a wizard in that one, guys. Some of those passes were absolutely magical. It was fun to watch.
Here's Dragic after Ben Simmons' bucket. Bosh passes to Dragic. Bosh with the bucket. Bosh has got his first basket of the night.
And Bosh knew he was going into the teeth of the defense. Still finds a way to get it done.
Embiid kicks to Bayless. 2 points. That one goes.
Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
Johnson outside. He feeds it to Bosh. Can't hit that one. And the 76ers go the other way with it. Last game matchup with the Suns, a tough loss there.
And you guys know how much I love aggressive defense. But in that game, they were just a bit over the top. And it wound up getting them in foul trouble.
That led the coach to make a bunch of makeshift lineups out there, guys playing different roles than they're used to. And predictably, that did not lead to a very precise performance.
Now, here's Bradley. Against Washington, he was really on his game. Back to Bosh. It's good for his second make. He's made 2 of 3 so far. The 76ers have gone 5 of 7 today so far. Nice shooting to get this game underway.
And for the Heat last season, they seemed to have a very defensive approach to how it is that they wanted to play. Challenged every shot. Did well on their rotations, and they definitely limited their opponent's scoring by slowing down the pace of the game.
As you said, the Heat pride themselves on their defensiveness and one of the best teams in the league, Brent, in opposing points per game.
Well, it shows you just how great a unit they are defensively, but you can't just have athleticism and tenacity on the defensive end. You have to have great communication on the back line, and I think that that's where the credit to the coaching staff has to go. They've gotten these guys to talk to each other on that end of the floor, and that's reaping some huge dividends.
Well, And some changes here for the 76ers. Robert Covington's checked in for Luau. And it's T.J. McConnell in for Jared Bayless. And a new group getting ready for Miami. David Lee's checked in for Johnson. Winslow comes in for James Johnson. Tyler Johnson, he's checked in for Avery Bradley. And it's Mills in for Goran Dragic.
Think back to the first couple years of Chris Bosh coming out of Georgia Tech into the NBA and how thin and slight he was and people wanting him to pack on pounds. All he did was pack on points, Kevin. They all saw his future as a back-to-the-basket big man. That's not what he has become, and he's become an all-star level, maybe even a Hall of Fame caliber player at the power forward position.
Here's McConnell, the Heat getting the bucket. Six to shoot. Embiid sets the pick for Simmons. Winslow pulls it down. Miami trailing. And thinking about Bosh and him never bulking up, really, he helped shift the mold of what the modern power forward is.
Well, the modern power forward has a good sense of the floor, has to be able to hit the outside shot and handle the basketball. Chris Bosh, coming into the league, had all of those tools at his disposal. And I don't think it was quite as big an adjustment for Chris Bosh. It was just about how much he could gain his confidence. He did that early.
Johnson outside. Here's Lee. Rebound by the 76ers.
Yeah, credit the D there. Got his hands up and made sure he wasn't comfortable on the release.
Well, sometimes coaches just tell you about changing shots rather than blocking shots. Something like that won't show up in the stat sheet, but just as important, trust me, coaches know.
Lee with the steal. Tipped away. It's the Heat on the break. Let's it go from 14. That's in, and he found his range with that one. Now one for two.
The lead changes hands once more. There has been no separation between these two teams.
Tonight they are here to compete. This is what the fans paid their money to see.
Covington shot is off. The Heat with the lead. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
Look, you just don't like turnovers ever, but they happen. Hopefully they'll learn from that mistake.
And the 76ers with some changes. Splitters checked in for Embiid. Sarge comes in for Rashawn Holmes. And it's Anderson in for Simmons. Here's McConnell. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Sarge dishes to Anderson. Puts it up from 12, and he hits the jump shot. Several lead changes going on here in the early portion of this game.
It reminds me of that Cameo song, back and forth.
Mills passes to Winslow, deflects the pass. Lets the three fly, connects from three-point range. Mills has got himself on the board with three there.
For all the strides he's made in other parts of his game, Mills remains at his heart a dead-eye three-point shooter.
A nice first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Miami ahead. They lead by a bucket. We'll take a quick break, then get you back to the action. Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from Miami, guys.
It's all about the depth, really. The bench has been the difference. The bench play really has separated these two teams.
And the front offices are always busy looking at that bench, trying to acquire spare parts that can make the difference.
The 76ers trailing. And the 76ers setting an all-time record for patience as far as going young, Greg, and building through the draft. There's been a lot of losing along the way.
Yeah, and a lot of questions to their strategy. I mean, but the front office said their philosophy was trying to plant an orchard from seeds. They didn't want to buy apples, I guess. They wanted to grow them from the ground up. Boy, they better get that harvest moving fast.
We've got Splitter. Jared Bayless is out there with Robert Covington. Then there's Anderson, and it's Saric in at the four. That's the group in the game for the 76ers. And Philadelphia making a change here. Luwawu's checked in. And Miami also making a switch. Bradley's checked in.
That's a bad turnover right there. But aside from that one, I think they've done a good job controlling the pace and the ball during the game.
Now here's Bayless. Doesn't go for him. The Heat shooting impressively throughout at 62%. Here's Bradley. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
Yeah, terrific play right there. Great strip to finish through the contact.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Every season, Brent, so much exciting young talent always coming into the NBA.
Well, that's what the league is really predicated on, is young drafted players who come in and change the fortunes of a franchise around. I think we're about to see some of that take place in Minnesota with Karl Anthony Towns.
One of my favorite young players, only 1 year at Kentucky.
And another guy who people look at with regards to his position, Kevin, and say they can't quite figure out what it is that he does not do well.
And it's the Heat with the ball after the Sixers pick up two. Baseline jumper, and the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Johnson. And here we can now take a look at how the ratio was between the threes and the twos last season for the 76ers.
And the long-range game, a staple for them offensively. It's clear they embrace the value of that extra point and spacing the floor, something they look to do every time they're on the court.
The 76ers trail by three. Poked loose. Lee with the steal. Near the three-point line, it's Dragic, and it's off the back rim, no good. And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Anderson the screen. Rocket six. Luwawu the pass to Splitter. And there before you are the teams that have been absolutely red hot for the last 10 games. Number one, the Heat.
Well, lately, their offense has been completely in sync. Guys are accepting their roles and playing unselfish basketball. That's helped them hit a high percentage of those opportunities.
Two shots.
And that one falls for Splitter.
Interesting to see Splitter really emerging from the free throw line. Struggled early in his career, but has been better every year since.
And Splitter drops them both.
And what a huge advantage when your bigs can be on the floor to get fouled and shoot free throws.
And Miami shooting around 60% on the night. Amazing work offensively so far.
And the way that the league is changing, you have to respect the fact that Eric Spoelstra has changed along with it. He's had a lot of small ball during the big 3 years. And he's been able to recognize when it's advantageous to go small with his roster for quite some time.
The Heat shooting their second and third free throws tonight. Free throw good from Bradley. And thinking about Spoelstra and how he was one of the few coaches to go small a couple years ago, Brent, you have to admire his flexibility in his approach.
Well, I think any coach really relishes the opportunity, Kevin, to have options on the floor. And when LeBron James is playing the four spot, he's a mismatch for everybody. Let's face it, when LeBron's on the floor for anybody at any position, he's a mismatch. But Eric Spoelstra did some thinking outside the box and got that team to play championship caliber basketball for four straight seasons.
Here's Luwawu. Back to Splitter. And it's Bayless in the corner. The pass to Luwawu. To the paint. Splitter misses.
The bucket just not well protected, but still he doesn't convert too often. That's been the story with him.
Johnson kicks to Johnson. Baseline Jay on the way. Miami no good on that time either.
Yeah, but the hand in the face. It's critical that you contest his shots every time down the floor.
Now here's Bayless. He's guarded closely. And it's Anderson atop the key. Misses off the left iron.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
And a moment now to look at the numbers for Lee. He's putting up 9 points a game, 8 rebounds, and 2 assists. And he's been a rock in the middle for them over that stretch of games. Dominating the glass is his trademark.
Embiid, he's checked in for the 76ers. Simmons comes in for Justin Anderson. And so David Lee nails them both.
As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more physical.
Pass to Luwawu. They set the screen. Here's Saric. The 76ers again can't hit it. The Heat leading by 5 and stolen by Simmons. And it's Bradley with the rebound. For Miami, they've gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter.
How about the activity of Simmons mucking up passing lanes and making life difficult on the opposition? So good at getting steals.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played. Bayless with it. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game. 4 on the shot clock. Saric, their offense, stone cold. Another miss there.
And the Sixers, you know, patiently building with young talent. And through all the losing, Coach Brett Brown talked about seeing the daylight. And I think we're starting to see it as well. The roster is starting to take shape. And maybe that optimism is just around the corner for the Sixers.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
As you look around the league, and the post-up is giving way to more and more pick and rolls, more and more three-point shooting. Some big men don't like it, but Amir Johnson embraces the change. He said, "It's what I do. I'm a big that likes to set screens and roll." Kevin, with his combination of range and finishing inside, has become one of the best at it in the game.
Very efficient, DA. Thanks. And the Sixers have drafted for talent rather than for need. A lot of front court players. You wonder, Greg, how it would all fit in.
And I think especially for a young team with so many needs, you are best served going with the best player available. They've evaluated how the pieces fit, and now they can make the moves necessary to complete that puzzle.
Some changes for Philadelphia. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for Saric. Robert Covington comes in, and it's T.J. McConnell in for Jared Bayless. And a new group in for the Heat. Chris Bosh is checked in for Lee. Justice Winslow comes in for Johnson. Johnson, he's checked in for Avery Bradley. It's Mills in for Goran Dragic. Here's Covington. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. And Simmons kicks to Holmes. And there it is for him.
And have not had as much success in the paint this quarter. Everything has been from the perimeter.
For Philadelphia, they have been successful on 3 of their 4 free throw attempts up to this point. And that one misses.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
To the inside. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
The Heat have been on target from the free throw line. They're 5 of 5 in that department.
Only shooting 71 really on the season, so there is plenty of room for improvement.
That free throw, no good.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. He's off on the second. Here's McConnell, and they cash in right away with the quick shot. McConnell's got his first points of the night.
How good is that? I mean, he can make a defender look foolish at times.
There's 47 seconds left now here in the second. Goes up on the block, and the rejection by Embiid. Goes up the baseline. Here's Holmes, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And how about the offensive rebound with a little extra punch on the putback?
You're right, Greg. As they look to trim the deficit, could we see them send a few more bodies to the boards from here on out? Maybe, just maybe. 26 seconds left in the first half. Now the dish to Mills. Ball's knocked loose. It's off his leg. And the ref saying he kicked it. There's 14 seconds left now here in the second. Here's Johnson. That one's rebounded by Embiid. Down low, here's Holmes, and the powerful one-handed slam.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball. And so it's a...
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you've enjoyed our first half of action. I'm Ernie Johnson welcoming you back. Shaquille O'Neal is right there. Kenny the Jet Smith is right there. And this here is the halftime report. It was a closely contested first quarter for Miami. At the end of the period, they held a two-point lead. They had a slight edge on the scoreboard in the second quarter, but only by the slimmest of margins. Kenny, let's start with you. What'd you think about the Heat?
They were really efficient on offense. Shared the basketball well, great shot selection. That accounted for a high field goal percentage in the first half.
Shaq, what'd you think about Philadelphia?
Aggressive. I called them up earlier. I like it. They're taking it hard to the rack, dictating the pace, setting the physical tone. You're not going to get that by launching threes all night. Everybody knows that.
All right, that is going to wrap up our halftime report, as it's just about time for the start of the third quarter.
The skyline of Philadelphia looking especially majestic tonight as we welcome you back to action. And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. The importance of the three-pointer growing and growing some more. It's becoming too prominent. What do you think?
I'm enjoying the game. I'm getting a little jealous.
I think everybody is, though.
Yeah, I'm getting a little jealous that I didn't play in this era, but interesting the way that coaches are seeking out the three-point line and in turn trying to create more space for the guys that can do more than just shoot threes, Kevin. So having versatility between one and four, a great screen setter that can roll and command some attention of the defense to suck in the defense. We always talk about the accordion of the defense, bringing them in, pulling them out, and taking advantage. I like the three-point shot. It's here to stay. Just don't mention four. Don't mention the four-point shot.
But some are.
Yeah, let's not go there.
On the floor for Miami, Dragic is out there with Brent. Then it's James Johnson. Then there's Chris Bosh. And it's Johnson in at the center. Let's it go from 11. The putback. Bosh grabs the miss.
And no connections yet so far, guys. 0 for 3 from the field.
It's good. Now it's a 7-point Heat lead.
And that solid play in the paint continues here, guys.
Embiid the screen. Holmes kicks to Embiid. And so he earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
And he's got his first free throw of the game. The free throw drops for Embiid. And Embiid drops them both. So it's Miami now. They've led by as many as 11 points. They defeated the Wizards in their last game.
I mean, no stress in that one. The game almost looked like a shoot-around for them. Amazing at how well they shot the basketball.
And on the road, don't forget, they loved being the bad guys that night. They sucked all the air out of the building with their ridiculous shooting.
Splitter has checked in for Philadelphia. Johnson inside. Splitter's there. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there. The Heat have gone 5 of 7 from the free throw line in the game.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good. Anderson, he's checked in for Simmons. And Johnson drops them both. Third quarter of basketball, about a minute and a half in. Here's Bayless. Pass to Llewellyn. The 76ers again can't hit it.
And honestly, not real happy with the shot selection on that one.
Yeah, you want your guys to attack with confidence, but that's just a bad look.
And nice job again. That time to add to their lead. They're doing everything right at the moment.
They're clearly dialed in, making each possession count. Now the challenge is, let's maintain that focus and concentration.
Six on the shot clock. Bayless the pass to Llewellyn. The 76ers with another miss.
Oof, ugly start to the second half. They're still scoreless in their first 5 attempts.
You know, around the league, Chris Bosh is thought about as such a versatile big man that still can dominate a game. Rare to have someone be so comfortable from anywhere on the floor with his size. Creating his own shot is very rare at the power forward spot, but expanding to the three-point line has made him devastating offensively.
No good on the free throw. And with Bosh in his play, he's still one of the best power forwards in the league. Right, you have to include his name into that conversation.
Well, don't let Eric Spoelstra's secrets out of the bag with what Chris Bosh does for him defensively. That's where he shows so much versatility as a 4 or 5 man, completely mobile out there, and it allows multiple pick and roll coverages.
And while we've got a moment, let's check out the best defenses in the NBA. Number one, the Heat.
And this team has been completely dominant. Fewest points per game allowed in the league. These guys are talented. They trust each other. They work together. And you just won't find better coaching on the defensive end of the floor.
Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now.
He's rising up and bringing the wood on that one. Could be just what they need to pick up their energy.
Well, Greg, it definitely got the guys on the bench on their feet, I'll say that. And that was Kia bringing you the close-up on the big-time play.
Yeah, but they're 3 of 4 to start the second half.
Anderson wide open, hands it from downtown. And now it's only a 5-point Heat lead. Left side, Bradley. Bosch dishes to Dragic, and it's good, 2 points.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Splitter sets a screen. Bayless with it, now guarded by Dragic. Now, here's Sarge. He's covered closely. Lee with the steal. And now, here's Lee, the fast break opportunity. That's good, and Johnson with the assist. And now it's a 9-point Heat lead.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Luwawu, the pass to Sarge. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Sarge has got his first bucket of the night. And Miami calls their first timeout of the game. Brent, they say the elite big man in the middle is a dying breed. What do you think? Any truth to that?
How about the birth of the new big man?
I would say so, too.
I just don't like to be so pessimistic about what it is that we used to see.
You see cycles, right, in the league?
Absolutely. So I'm more of one of those guys' glasses half full. So let's celebrate the versatility, the mobility, and the incredible talent of the young players at their size being able to be as effective as they are in the NBA.
The 76ers with some changes. Robert Covington's checked in for Luau. And it's T.J. McConnell in for Jared Bayless. And then for Miami, Winslow's checked in for Johnson. Johnson comes in for Bradley. And it's Mills in for Goran Dragic. Miami leading by 7. And Mills kicks to Lee. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
And while he's better known for scoring than playing the PG position in a traditional sense, Patty Mills becoming a better playmaker.
They set the pick. Pass to Sarge. And the layup falls. Sarge has got 4 points this quarter.
He really did a nice job of getting the ball into an area where good things tend to happen. And they did.
And Mills kicks to Bosch, and he gets it to go. And the Heat lead by 9.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
McConnell kicks to Sarge. Dishes to Splitter, stolen by Bosch. Shot's good by Sarge. Sarge has got 6.
Ooh, good eyes, found the open man and delivered an accurate pass.
Lee, and the layup's good off the glass.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their 5th consecutive make in the paint.
Covington dishes the Splitter. Sarge has the open look. That one, no good. And Miami the other way now. And this is the first season matchup for them against this 76ers team.
Yeah, and they came out with a W every time they played this squad last year. A stark contrast drawn between the conference's haves and have-nots.
Here's Covington. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. It's his first trip to the line.
Robert Covington. 2 shots.
And the first one drops. Among some changes here for the 76ers. Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Splitter. Rashawn Holmes comes in for Saric. And Simmons subbed in for Justin Anderson. And Miami with a change here, too. Johnson, he's checked in for Lee. And both free throws good for Covington.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
Johnson kicks to Johnson. That one falls, coming off Johnson's feet. And it's 8 points for Johnson.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
Here's McConnell, covered by Mills. McConnell passes to Embiid with one on the clock. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Miami ahead, up by 11. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. Welcome you back as we get going here in the fourth quarter. The final quarter of play can change everything. And Miami has possession. They've got Simmons. Robert Covington out there with Joel Embiid. And it's Holmes in at the power forward position. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. Johnson kicks to Mills. Bosch dishes to Mills. Embiid with the steal. Here's Covington. He's guarded by Johnson. Mills with the steal. Johnson, the pass to Johnson. Good ball movement here by the Heat. Winslow kicks to Johnson. Mills dishes to Bosch. That's tipped. Winslow, the pass to Johnson. Here's Mills. That's good, and it's Johnson with the assist. Johnson's got his third assist on the night.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
The pass to Holmes to the wing right side. Here's Embiid. Misses the three. The Heat leading by 13. Johnson kicks to Johnson. And Embiid with the block. And now the 76ers on the break. Here's Holmes. No good off the back of the rim.
Now, nice work there to contest the finish inside.
The only way you're going to challenge him in that situation, you have to attack with more power.
And the foul is called. He intentionally grabbed him there for some reason. I don't know.
Kevin, all I can think of is that he's trying to slow the game down a little bit. That's a stretch, though. Definitely a strange move on his part.
Jared Bayless has checked in for T.J. McConnell. Johnson, he's checked in for Miami. The 76ers making a switch here. Luwawu's checked in. The Heat also with a sub. Goran Dragic has checked in for Patty Mills. He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, during the break, I listened in on Brett Brown's huddle with his team. No surprise, he was not happy with the turnovers. He told them, "We are giving this one away, guys. We've got to be more careful with the ball. Play within the offense and get good open shots." Kevin?
And there's the foul. It'll go on Jared Bayless. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Oh, great defense. They anticipated the play and got there first.
Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Johnson dishes to Johnson. Back to Johnson from 10 feet out. And the rejection by Embiid. They get it back. And the whistle blows as the basket counts. And a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
Brent, you think about free throws, getting a shooting foul is one of the best outcomes offensively for most players, and we've got guys in this league that can really do it well.
Still one of the most important aspects, Kevin, of an offensive thrust is to show the officials during any game that you're willing to attack the rim and go in there with fearlessness. Most of those guys end up getting to the free throw line and shooting very effective shots. You're always looking for 1 point per possession. And if you can step to the free throw line with nobody around you unguarded and knock a couple down, it benefits your team.
How often, though, do you think that's the best shot as opposed to driving, drawing a couple defenders in there, then kicking it out?
Well, I think
what the analytics would say on that.
Well, I think you have to be really selective on who it is that you're kicking it out to. But certainly the free throw is one of the most important shots in the game of basketball. And usually the most aggressive team is going to shoot more on a nightly basis.
Outside Dragic, Johnson in the corner, kicks to Johnson. And the rejection by Embiid.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Luau, the pass to Holmes, feeds it to Bayless. Here's Holmes. No good from Luau.
Well, he's a great finisher around the rim, but some stellar defense there stopped that from happening.
And now Philadelphia on the break. Bayless leading the charge.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yep, he got up ahead of steam and no one could come over to stop him.
Johnson attacking and Embiid with the block. And Embiid throws it down.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And nice court vision from Dragic there to get a great look at the bucket.
There's the feed to Embiid. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. The free throw drops for Embiid. Chris Bosch is checked in for the Heat. Bradley comes in for Johnson. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Miami leading by nine. It's tipped. Here's Luau, guarded by Bradley. Embiid wide open. No good from outside. Got the defender off his feet with the pump fake, but couldn't knock it down. And they pick up two. And it's 7 points for Avery Bradley. Timeout called, the 76ers. They're trailing by 11. We've got 1:48 left in the fourth quarter.
You know, he just, like every other coach, can't stand when the defense gives up points on the inside. And boy, are they struggling in there.
Now, some of that right now might be a lack of toughness, but you can't combine that with laziness. Guys are not crashing down and closing off those driving lanes.
Let's it go from 14.
It looked like he was in rhythm to shoot that one, guys, especially as open as he was. Just clanged it.
And Luau gets it to go. There's a minute 34 left in the fourth quarter of this one. On the wing, Johnson. He kicks to Bosch. Johnson dishes to Bosch. Good ball movement here by the Heat. Down to five on the shot clock. Johnson's shot is off.
And he's really having all sorts of problems with his jumper right now.
This is one of those slumps that you'll just probably want to shoot your way out of.
Outstanding entry pass there. He knew exactly where to go with the ball.
It's Bradley on the wing. Connects on the foul line jumper. Here's Bayless. 55 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. And good that time.
Hit his teammate right in stride. That's a great assist.
Here's Trogic. Takes it off the glass. And the Heat lead by eight.
And if you thought this game was over already, you're probably right.
Well, let's give credit to where it is due. They refused to take their foot off the gas pedal, even after it was obvious they were in full control of this basketball game.
There's 45 seconds left in the fourth. Embiid, no good.
Ill-advised shot there.
And he knows it. Got locked into scoring mode. Couldn't pull it back.
Bradley kicks to Dragic. Here's Johnson. And another basket for Miami.
Timeout.
Terrific run to seal the deal.
Yeah, as time became a factor, they became the aggressors. Big time finish to pull away.
And the 76ers call time here. They trail by 10. We've got 28 seconds left in the game. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Splitter sets a screen. Saric passes to Splitter. Anderson outside. Not really his range, and it's off target. There's Winslow.
Fearless play by Winslow, putting his head down and barreling in with great focus.
And the first one drops. He doesn't get the second one.
Well, he got the important one to go. Their lead should be safe now.
Anderson, no one around him. Here's Anderson. It's stolen by Bradley. And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. Goran, what has been the key to the success of this team lately and the key tonight?
In the last two games, everybody is playing for each other. You know, we're sharing the ball. We are active in defense and we run. I think so. Last two games, that was the key. Everybody was involved. Everybody was shooting the ball well, and here's the result.
Yeah, everything's working really well for you right now. Thanks for the time. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. And now to our good friend Ernie Johnson, who is standing by in the studio.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. It is time now to present our Jordan player of the game, David Lee. Starting the second half, he came out with a nice stretch, hitting four in a row to help fuel their third quarter.
As good as he was tonight, he had those fans thinking, who is this guy? Who he play for? This guy came off the bench on the road and proceeds to tear them apart. A coach never counts on that kind of contribution from the bench, but he loves it when he gets it. You sure this guy needs to be coming off the bench, coach?
He was outrageous. He shot a rare shooting percentage from the field, hitting from everywhere. It didn't matter where he was or who was guarding him. The defense tried to make adjustments, so what? Still knocked down shots.
That's going to do it for our broadcast tonight. We certainly hope you've enjoyed the show, don't we, guys?
It was great.
Yeah. Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, and for Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew. All 653,000 of them.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Hardworking.
A lot of people.
Yeah. It's a long line at the buffet, though.
Yeah. Shout out to the T-poles, man.
Oh. Yes.